unclaimed mind, unclaimed body, abandoned mercilessly in the bleak alley of this dark, drab city. Oh God, could anybody come forward and help me out? Sisters must have looked around. Mothers must have waited at the doors. Old fathers must have gazed around. Oh Kashmiri, you turned to death brutally. Unclaimed body, abandoned mercilessly. Wet eyes, trembling lips, songs of feelings, mournful mornings and glooming evenings. This is Kashmir. Mr. President, whenever I talk about peace, I see the burning valleys of Kashmir. Whenever I talk about freedom, I see the Indian occupied Kashmir. And whenever I talk about human rights, I see the innocent Kashmiris blinded with pellet guns to have their rights. And this is what I mean to be here at this platform, that human rights violation in IOK and role of international community. Ladies and gentlemen, what are human rights? According to Universal Declaration of Human Rights, Article 1 and 3, all human beings are born free and equal in dignity and rights. According to UN Resolution of 13th August 1947 and 5th January 1949, India have shown their commitment for right to self-determination of Kashmiris. Harassment and atmosphere of depression prevails on this land since 1947. From the very first day, India is involved in human rights violation. Mr. President, allow me to ask a few questions to the Indian brutal government. To snatch the bean of innocent children is not human rights violation. To detain the whole population of the valley is not human rights violation. To deprive the Kashmiris from right of free expression is not human rights violation. Since last, ladies and gentlemen, since last couple of years, the Kashmir Valley is turned into an airlock prison. People have detained inside their homes. There is scarcity of food, water, and other necessities of life are not available. Excessive use of security forces and state barred by India has turned the Kashmir Valley into human tragedy and graveyard. Mr. President, there are about 25 resolutions calling for the solution of this dispute, but India is reluctant to grant Kashmiris their right of self-determination by denying the implementation of these resolutions and occupying the state by 7 lakh troops. Every human being has a right to life, and nobody can deprive him arbitrarily. Article 6 of ICCPR protect this right. Ladies and gentlemen, if the SOS Venezuela, if Taiwanese Sunflower Movement, if Thailand Three Fingers Salute, if Mexico's 43 were honored up to their merits, then why, my lord, why 14 years old Insha Malik with her bedazzled eyes punctured by parrot is not noticed? Why, my lord, why Burhan murder is neglected? Why, my lord, why 24 years old Farooq Ahmed Dar tied in front of a military jeep used as a human shield against the protester is not noticed? It has been affirmed by the International Court of Justice in Namibia, in Western Sahara, and is democracy that all human rights, including right to self-determination, is the fundamental right of all the people. I don't understand the dual standards of international community. World intervened when it came to South Sudan and East Timor. But when it comes to Kashmir, they stop themselves due to various strategic, political, and economic standards related to India. Now, when both the countries related to this problem has become the atomic powers, it needs the attention of the world to solve the Kashmir dispute. Moscow could use his influence in New Delhi to persuade the Indians to be more pragmatic and sincere to solve the Kashmir dispute. Beijing could play a vital role, as it has occupied a significant place in world politics, and there must be assistant diplomacy on behalf of Pakistan to get them on board regarding the final settlement of this dispute. the European Union should mount pressure upon Indian authorities to shun its arrogant and naughty behaviors to make a headway in this long, vexed dispute. The OIC, especially the Saudi Arabia, could lead coalition in order to convince the India to reach the issue's logical end. Mr. President, at the end, I would say that I consider myself as a son of Kashmir and the biggest stakeholder. And by saying that, Mr. President, I urge the UN to implement its resolution, and the Secretary General must use his good office to mediate a just, peaceful, and democratic solution to the human rights crisis in Kashmir. Let me allow to mention, the world must realize that the Kashmiris are not begging for their freedom, but they are struggling for their freedom as their fundamental right. Let the people of Kashmir decide about their future. Kashmiris want freedom. They want freedom from brutality. They want freedom from injustice. They want peace. Because peace is like a flower. It's pleasant like a shore. Refreshing like the morning sun. It's what makes a survival one. Thank you.